हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग द फिफ्थ लेसन ट्रेडर्स टू रूलर्स। आई डिस्कस्ड विद यू अप टू राइवलरी इन ट्रेड ऑफ द यूरोपियन कंपनीज। नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट द एंग्लो फ्रेंच राइवलरी एंड कार्नेटिक वॉर्स। So due to the rivalry in trade, the French and the Britishers, they fought each others. So these wars are known as the Carnatic Wars. So there were three Carnatic Wars between the Britishers and the French during the half of the 18th century. These wars were called Carnatic Wars because these wars were caused in the Carnatic region of the South India. Carnatic refers to an area occupied by the Kannad speaking people, which roughly corresponds to a part of the modern Indian state of Karnataka. The eastern part of the coastal Carnatic was under Hyderabad within the Mughal Empire. The Carnatic War mostly was caused between the French and the British companies. These wars were caused because of the two wars of these Carnatic, three Carnatic Wars were caused due to the continuation of the wars in the Europe. First was the continuation of the war of the war of Austrian succession 1740 to 1748, and the second war was the continuation of the 7 years war from 1756 to 1763. The first and the third Carnatic War was because of the continuation of these two wars in India. The European powers who had all aligned themselves with the native princes took leadership of many of the battles. These wars were caused due to the breaking down of the Mughal Empire in India and the increase of the European power, which influenced their regions. The Carnatic Wars were driven by opportunism on all sides. Now the first Carnatic War, which was caused between 1744 to 1748, the French East India Company was established in Pondicherry and the British station was in the Madras. The French East India Company wanted to capture the British station, which was in Madras. The Indian ruler who was there at that time, he wanted to stop the French for capturing the Madras, but French refused to do so. The French company, they captured Madras, and also they captured the army and the governor or the French chief general called the American sorry the British general called the Robert Clive. Robert Clive was also captured by the French. Later the Robert Clive and the army, British army, they asked help from the British company. They sent their company to the Madras, and then the Madras was taken again by the British army. So this happened because of the stop of the continuation of the wars of Austrian succession in Europe. So there was an agreement between the French and the British, not to fight against each other, as the French were led by Dupleix and the British by Lord Clive. The Second Carnatic War was between 1748 to 1754. This war was caused mainly due to the succession of the native rulers of the Kingdom of Hyderabad and the Carnatic. In Hyderabad, Muzaffar Jung became the ruler of Nawab with French support. War was finally concluded in 1754 when the French governor initiated peace talks and we called Dupleix. Now the Third Carnatic War, which was caused between 1756 to 1763. This war was the continuation of the war, 7 years war in the Europe. So when this war in Europe stopped, then the war in India also stopped. The British won the Carnatic Wars because they were more powerful, they had a better navy, and also they were supported by the British government and they enjoyed the autonomy. Now the British conquest of Bengal. The English East India Company was merely a trading center in early 17th century, but slowly they started making forts in different parts of India. During 1651, they made the factory in Hooghly. At this time, Aurangzeb was the Mughal emperor, so he started pushing them out of that factory. So after that, he allowed the Portuguese to trade with the India, and he also allowed them trading rights. But after the Aurangzeb death, the Mughal Empire became weak and company increased its operations in Bengal. In 1717, Farrukh Siyar, the Mughal Emperor, gave the Diwani right, that is the tax-free trade, to the British Empire or the British Company. So they were free to import and export trade without giving tax to the Mughal Empire. But they started doing illegal activities and they did not pay trade duties. This resulted in an enormous loss of revenue for Bengal. Now the conflict between the company and the Nawabs of Bengal. After Farrukh Siyar, the Nawabs of Bengal, they became very angry and they thought not to give tax-free trade to the British company. So in this, the different Nawabs of Bengal, Murshid Quli Khan, Sirajuddaulah and Ali Wardi Khan, they were very strong rulers and they were against the tax-free trade to British company. Ali Wardi Khan laid down certain condition to the British company to trade with India or the Bengal. The official of the company who were engaged in private trade shall pay custom duties or the privileged duty. Free trade will be withdrawn altogether. So if they did trade without paying tax, then the trading rights of the British company would be withdrawn. The second condition was they should stop the fortification of the company. Nawabs forbid the company from minting coins. He also ordered that the company, if they are trading with a large amount, then they had to pay tax in also in large. Causes of the conflict. The company did not follow the orders of the Nawabs of Bengal. So the as company was more powerful than the Nawab of Bengal, so they also had military access. So French and military success against the French both in Europe and in India, the British company were becoming more powerful. This became worsened in 1756 when the Nawab of Bengal Sirajuddaula became furious of the company's interference in the affairs of Bengal. He gave an order to stop the expansion of fortification, but they refused to do so. And when the negotiations were failed, the Sirajuddaula captured the English factory at Kasim Bazar and the company's fort at Calcutta. Soon Robert Clive took charge of the company's affairs and trade privileges by treacherous means. Now, the Battle of Plassey was caused in 1757 between Sirajuddaula and the British company. The beginning of British political control over India may be traced back to the Battle of Plassey in 1757. So this was the important battle for the British company and also for the Nawab of Bengal. The British company did not follow the order of the Sirajuddaula, so this battle was caused. The British officer Robert Clive, he conspired with Mir Jafar, who was the commander-in-chief of the Sirajuddaula, and Mir Jafar did not turn up when the Battle of Plassey took place. This caused a lot of loss for Sirajuddaula, and Sirajuddaula was defeated by the British company, and Mir Jafar became the Nawab of Bengal. The British company wanted a puppet ruler so that the Nawab could do so. So Mir Jafar was also the puppet ruler in the hand of British company. British Battle of Plassey is significant as it transformed a mere trading company into a political power. Bengal after Plassey. Mir Jafar became the Nawab of Bengal, and as I told you, he was a puppet ruler in the hand of the company. Company wanted more and more tax from him, but he was not able to give more tax, more revenue to the company. So company disbanded Mir Jafar, and they made Mir Qasim in 1760 as the Nawab of Bengal. Mir Qasim gave the company the Jamindari of Bardhaman, Midnapur and Chittagong. Mir Qasim did not want to be act as a puppet ruler, so he refused to give the tax to the British company. He started disobeying British company. He abolished all duties on internal trade. As a result, Indian merchants were able to enjoy the concessions which only English had enjoyed so far. Mir Qasim also placed limits on the trade privileges of the company. Now the Battle of Buxar, which was caused in 1764. So due to the refusal of Mir Qasim to give the tax to the British company, this war was caused. The company became angry and furious from the Mir Qasim, and they declared war against Mir Qasim. Mir Qasim fled to Awadh and took help of Shujauddaula of Awadh and the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II. Their combined forces in 22 October 1764, they fought the Battle of Buxar, but they were defeated as their army was not so strong than the British army. So with this victory of the Battle of Buxar, the company became the real master of Bengal. I am concluding this lesson up to this, and I will continue the lesson in the next video. So thank you for watching this video, and if you have any problem, you can comment in the comment box. Thank you.